Hey YouTube, today I'm gonna show you my Batcave set. You know, one that came out earlier last year or something. I've actually had it for like a month. Just been kind of procrastinating making very many videos because I just found like the 7th season of Doctor Who on Amazon Instant. But yeah. It wasn't on Netflix, so, oh well. Oh well, let's get to the point. So basically, we'll get to the villains later. In fact, just take that out of the... Get to the villains later. And, first we got this nice bat cycle. You get a lot of those. That's a sticker. Nice. Nice little small build. Flick fire missiles as usual. It's like the traditional, usual. Somewhat redundant. Not everyone likes them, but we still get them. Oh well. So that's nice. You get Bruce Wayne. Sorry for glare. This just nice blue 2 or 3 piece suit. Oh no. Only the one sided head. Won't bother showing you the other side. Slicked back hair. Adam West style Batman. Yep. Big deal. Well, I guess you kind of need a hero, but, it's blue, gray and blue, hold on. My room used to be brighter, I don't know why. It's the other side. Back printing. This is the face. I mean, this minifigure really could represent Adam West if you made him, like, all with the goofy expression. Like, do a really good job of it. Here's Robin. You get him in, like, what, one other set? Yeah. So it's just like the nice, neat combed hair. It's back printing. That's the other face. Let's look at the Batcave. There's the phone and bat gear. That old, like, remote control battering right there is actually supposed to be a normal one. I just, you know, I customize my sets. But those handcuffs they were supposed to be binoculars where those handcuffs were. But, oh well, Batman doesn't really need binoculars. It's just in the cowl, you know? So, I moved the handcuffs there and put the remote claw there. Holding cell, which by the way is detachable. Oh, sorry. And, yeah. This is the holding cell. A second. We're supposed to put poison ivy in there, but I'm like, you don't really need to. Like, you can just pull a Lego movie set, put a red stud there, which I did, but I took it off for review, you know. has those stickers on the side. Plants. Flick fire. This turns. Holding cell. Sign. This can easily come out, which is how you put poison ivy in there, and how you could have Bane break her out. Yeah, it's always nice to have play features. Otherwise, the set isn't fun and it won't sell. And then Lego isn't happy. So you can just chuck her in there. And, I don't know. I'm just being kind of sloppy with that. Just put it back in there. And that's where it goes. Just right there. Just clicks in. Those holes. Just go right there. Hold on. Stupid soft surface. Okay. That worked. Those little lightsaber blades are actually supposed to represent steps. Show you what I mean in a second. This is the back of it. So really nothing fancy, just like some extra area that for some reason is empty. I'm not sure why that is empty. I'll probably fill that in. That little rod right there helps with a play feature that I'll show in a minute. That's the little bridge with the little bat hanging on to it. It can come off pretty easily, just like a small little build. I did not actually mean to pull the whole thing off, but oh well. So that bit of the back cave is separate. So put that down. Then we'll move on to this bit of the back cave. Again, I'll show you the whole big suit changing station play feature later. This is the other back computer section. It's the back computer, some lights in that. Ladder to get up. Dun, dun. Bat symbol. This is a nice little chair. A lot of people were disappointed by this, but I'm like, because I don't own the old Batcave set, I'm like, it's fine. I like how it's like the hologram kind of screen. By the way, that comes off pretty easily. Bat computer comes off pretty easily. It just kind of bends open. Yeah, those are all stickers. The bat symbol right there is not a sticker. The alert signs. Pretty much that is the only printed piece in the set, excluding that piece, which is part of Bane's mole machine, which we haven't got to that yet. So just chill. These doors will open up from the back. Gonna put the back computer back on. So that would suck if Batman woke up and he's like, what the heck? Where is my computer? This is the back. It's a nice little amount of room to go through. This fits nicely. Then there are some T-slopes there to keep them from falling off, and those will keep it from falling out. Those pieces will stop them from going in any farther. And you can put, like, spare minifigures there. Spare minifigs. But then it won't really be able to open all the way, so it's not really completely great. That's it for this section. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You're putting off the suit changing thing. I haven't. I'm not. I'm just, well, actually, yeah, I am. But, it's Bane's mall machine. If you turn it, it'll go forward. Kind of like Cole's power drill that I reviewed earlier. Those are all stickers, except for that printed piece. Here's the light, so it just goes forward. Sorry for the background piano music, if you can hear that. Bane, he's holding his dynamite. As you can see, he looks very strong. Has all those marks. He has back printing on the head too. Tube goes down into the Venom pack. So it really is just like he pretend that there's no gap right there. That's it for Bane. Now, I actually completely forgot to review Poison Ivy. This is Poison Ivy. And this is a 12-minute video in, like, 1 second now. Yep. Not sure if YouTube will let me post that because I don't have enough subscribers. Hairpiece is printed, which is nice. Unique color. Has the smirk. Then there's also back printing with the alternate expression. That's it for that bit. Now, for the maybe not so long anticipated other feature with the, hold on, bat suit changing station. Man, I'm so sorry, guys. You just put any Batman down there. You push him up. Then there's this rod piece that goes, like I mentioned earlier, you can't see that, into the back. Just slips in, and they can kind of find where it should fit, and it comes out pretty easily. That's how it gets locked. There's Bruce Wayne. Or really, any minifigure can go on either one. And so you just take out the rod. Do my best to hope you guys can see this. Oops, my bad. Sorry. Ouch. I know what this video should be called. Jabot fails. Majorly. Anyway, I like that. I'm going to assume you guys saw that. It's kind of tricky. Sorry. Also, sorry that I flipped.